border security battle has reignited ahead of the federal election. The government is claiming that Labor will restart the people smuggling trade. So what is this fight all about? And why is the Christmas Island Detention Centre being reopened? This is a debate that has been running since the turn of the century. So let's start with a little history lesson. The security of our borders is an issue the Coalition has successfully fought an election on twice before. Prime Minister John Howard was trailing in the polls in 2001 at a time when the number of asylum seeker boats was on the rise. When a Norwegian freighter, the Tampa, picked up 433 refugees at sea and sailed towards Australia, Prime Minister Howard made a dramatic intervention, sending in the SAS to stop the ship from docking at Christmas Island.
We will decide who comes to this country and the circumstances in which they come.
He then introduced the Pacific Solution, forcing refugees and asylum seekers arriving by boat to be processed in offshore detention centres on Nauru and Manus Island. It was just before the federal election, and John Howard went on to claim what had appeared to be an unlikely victory on the back of this issue and the September 11 terror attacks. And the policy worked. The boats stopped coming. In 2001, there were 43 boats carrying 5,516 people. The following year, there was one boat carrying one person. When Labor's Kevin Rudd became Prime Minister in 2007, he scrapped the Pacific Solution, and the trickle of boats turned into a flood, rising every year between 2009 and 2013, when it peaked at 300 boats carrying 20,587 people.
He has rolled out the Rudd carpet to the people smugglers.
Under pressure, Labor reopened Manus Island and Nauru, something that it had pledged to never do.
My government is not interested in pursuing a new Pacific solution.
At the 2013 election, the Coalition campaigned hard on restoring the Howard-era border plan, calling it Operation Sovereign Borders and pledging to turn asylum seeker boats back on the high seas. Again, the boats stopped, dropping from 300 to 1 in 1 year. Scott Morrison was Immigration Minister at the time. He led the hardline border protection regime. So why has this fight come up again? Well, the latest round of this battle fired up in February. That's when the government lost an historic vote on legislation in the lower house. Labor, the Greens and the Independents teamed up to pass a bill to transfer asylum seekers from Manus Island and Nauru to Australia for medical treatment. The loss was seen as a major blow for the Morrison government, showing that it did not control the lower house. But the Prime Minister is determined to turn it to his political advantage, using it to accuse the opposition leader of being soft on border protection and claim that if elected, Labor will again reboot the people smuggling trade.
Australia is strong enough to treat people humanely.
He has led this process to weaken and compromise our borders.
To demonstrate how hardline he is, Scott Morrison's declared any asylum seekers needing medical treatment will be taken to Christmas Island, not mainland Australia. So what is the Christmas Island Detention Centre? Well, Christmas Island is an Australian territory. It's about 350 kilometres from Indonesia. In 2018, its detention centre was mothballed after years of unrest, riots and hunger strikes. Now it's reopening as a place to house asylum seekers who are transferred for medical treatment or assessment. To illustrate his border protection credentials, Scott Morrison became the first Prime Minister to officially visit the island. Now, his trip went against everything that we have seen from the government in the last 6 years. Until now, the inside of the detention centre has been off limits to media. But when Mr Morrison went, he invited cameras inside, and his message was clear.
The last thing I ever wanted to do was reopen it. But here we are. Thank you, Bill Shorten. But I can tell you the only bit of Australia they'll see is some of those accommodation blocks.
Labor labelled the visit an expensive stunt.
You know, a frolic to Christmas Island. What a waste of money.
So when the Medivac bill passed, Labor wanted to highlight the weaknesses of the Morrison minority government. But Labor has handed the Prime Minister a chance to make boat arrivals a key battleground in the election campaign. It's worked for the Coalition at the polls before, and Scott Morrison is hoping it'll work again.